Hi guys, welcome to NRL. I'm Dr. Jas Sanghera, branch head of Optical Materials and Devices branch. I would like to talk to you today about the phenomenal work that our scientists and engineers are doing in the design and fabrication of fiber laser. So you might be wondering, what is a fiber laser? Come on in, I'll show you. Fiber laser is made from optical fibers like the one I'm holding here. Believe it or not, I am actually holding a fiber. It's about the thickness of a human hair. It's the same kind of fiber that's used in telecommunications. The only difference is we figured out how to convert this into fiber laser that has higher power, higher efficiency, and allows us to generate wavelengths that are difficult to attain via traditional processing. Okay, so the optical fiber actually starts life as a glass rod, which we call the optical preform, which is more than 100 times thicker than the optical fiber I'm holding in my left hand. So guys, why don't we go into the lab and see how we make these optical preforms? So why don't you follow me? So we make these optical preforms in-house using custom equipment. The key feature is that we place the rare earth ions inside the core using nanoparticle doping. And what I'm going to do is introduce you to Dr. Colin Baker, who's going to show you how we make the optical preforms.
Hi, Jas.
Hi, Colin. You're going to show these guys how you make the optical preforms?
Sure, come on in. Welcome to the Modified Chemical Vapor Deposition Lab, or MCVD Lab. This is where we create the high purity optical preform that will be drawn into optical fiber. Now, in order for an optical fiber to work, you have to have a cladding and a core layer which will guide the light. Not only are we creating fibers that guide light, we're creating fibers that will create an amplifier for optical gain. And we do that by incorporating rare earth ions inside of the fiber. But we're doing something special in this lab. Here we have rare earth ions that are incorporated inside of a nanoparticle host in a stable dispersion. That dispersion will then be incorporated into the preform on the MCVD lathe shown here.
The process starts with the silica glass tube, which is incorporated into the MCVD lathe. Next, a vapor and a gas are introduced inside the tube, and they react to form a porous silica soot. At this point, our proprietary nanoparticle dispersion is introduced into the exhaust end so that it can be soaked into the porous soot that we've created. Under high heat, we consolidate and collapse the preform into the solid rod. This will create the core and cladding. Now we have the completed optical preform, specifically tailored to operate in the eye safer wavelengths.
Just like this one, which is ready for fiber draw. Here you go, Jas.
Hi, Colin, thanks a lot. Guys, wasn't that cool? So we're gonna go down to the next lab here, and I'm gonna show you some more cool stuff and hand you over to Dan Ronhaus and his team. Hi, Dan, let me hand over the preform to you.
Thank you.
And so I'm gonna see you in a short while.
So now that we have an optical preform, we're gonna go upstairs and I'll show you the first step in the process. So this is John. John has taken a preform just like this one. He's preloaded it into our draw tower. So let's go over to the draw tower and see how we start the process. So as you can see, the preform is loaded into the tower. This preform is going to be loaded into our furnace, and the furnace is sitting at about 2,000 degrees centigrade. The preform will start to soften, and when it becomes soft enough that it can't support itself, it will drop from the furnace and it will trail a piece of fiber behind it. John and the other guys below will gather the fiber and they will pull it into a spool, and that's basically how we pull the fiber. So at the end of the fiber draw process, what we end up with is a very long spool of optical fiber. And now I'm gonna hand it off to Jas and he's gonna show you the next step of the process.
Dan and John, guys, really appreciate it. Thanks so much, see you later. Wasn't that cool, guys? So what I'm gonna do now is take you on to the next step in the process. So this fiber is at the heart of a laser system. And I'm gonna introduce you to Dr. Brenda Sean and his team, who are gonna take this fiber and incorporate that in a fiber laser system. Hi, Brandon, here's the fiber.
Okay, come on in, guys.
Once we have the fiber, we'll be integrating it to a fiber laser system. The team, Raphael, Gus, and Chris, will take the fiber and basically integrated into a fiber laser system. This is an example of a fiber integrated into a prototype system. The fiber is spliced into the system with diodes and other components and put onto a cold plate. And this will be integrated into a chassis for delivering to the customer.
We work very closely with our DoD customers and program offices to design, develop, and build these systems that can operate at any and all wavelengths, including the eye-safer wavelengths. This is the only facility inside of DoD that can go from raw materials to completed custom laser systems.
So, I hope you enjoyed your visit to NRL today and saw these unique facilities we have under one roof to fabricate optical fibers, optical preforms, fiber lasers incorporating these fibers, and especially exploiting these nanoparticles that allow us to make fiber lasers that have high efficiency, high power, and generate wavelengths that you cannot do via traditional techniques in support of Department of Navy and the Department of Defense. So I hope you enjoyed your visit, NRL, and goodbye for now. And I hope to see you back here very soon. So bye for now.